Check the number. Check the number one. Check the number. Check the number one. Check the number. Check the number one. Check the number. Check the number one.
We'll be right back.
number one. Check the number. Check the number. Check the number. Check the number.
Thank you. We'll be right back. upstanding father figure upon whom he could rely. When the Wolfman returned after the war for his second period of analysis, he had lost all his money. Freud treated him free, personally helped him financially.
Apple. was that this encouraged the flow of free association. The second, Freud's admission that he shrank from being stared at for 8 or more hours a day. A third reason was that Freud thought it desirable that the patient should not be aware of the psychoanalyst's changing facial expressions. All three reasons have a certain validity, and most Freudian analysts. Of the inheritance of acquired characteristics. In spite of his considerable knowledge of Darwin, whose evolutionary theory had displaced Lamarck's ideas in the minds of virtually every biologist, Freud obstinately maintained until his death that acquired characteristics could be inherited, and that the origins of religion and morality could indeed be traced back. There are a number of untenable elements in Freud. material from studies of subhuman primates that a primal horde dominated by a single male ever existed. Darwin derived his notion from hearsay reports about the organization of guerrilla troops, which have since been shown to be false. Second, totemic meals are rare and found only in a small minority of tribes professing totemism. Third, Freud neglects any discussion of the possible importance of the mother in totemic religion, an omission characteristic of psychoanalytic theory, which, until late in its evolution, habitually emphasized the father's role at the expense of that of the mother. This emphasis probably originated from the fact that Freud himself had more problems in his relation to his father than he did in relation to his mother. Fourth, in at least one of the cases upon which Freud based his theory of the totem representing the father, a quite different interpretation is possible. In the light of modern anthropology, Darwinian theory, and Bowlby's work on attachment, it is easy to be wise after the event and accuse Freud of neglecting evidence to some of which he could not at that time have had access. Nevertheless, totem and taboo does belong to the wilder shores of speculation and bears witness to Freud's tendency to generalization from an insufficient basis of fact when he thought that he could thereby find support for psychoanalytic theory.